Liverpool 0, Real Madrid 1. Yeah. Gutting. Absolutely gutting to come so close to, you know, the ultimate historic moment in football, to miss out on the league title and then to come all the way to Paris and to lose like that to Real Madrid. I can't be here and be like, oh, glass half full, glass half full. What I would say is I remember doing this video after Kiev. We were losing to Real Madrid and saying, Liverpool need to stop inventing new ways to break our hearts. And the best thing about this, and it's the only really good thing about it, is that I don't feel that way about Liverpool anymore. Liverpool have invented new ways to make our hearts sore in the last 4 years or more. So while tonight was an absolute kick of the teeth, because to come this way, and the setup was wonderful, the fan park was exceptional, Jamie Webster absolutely kicked the shit out of it again, as he does, absolute legend. Obviously I want to talk a little bit about the staging, which was horrendous. The environment from minute one, from arriving at the station at Stade de France, was terrible. The organisation, the infrastructure, terrible. We didn't see how it got really, really hairy later on, but it was bad, and we got here 2 hours before kickoff, and it was terrible. And, you know, Madrid fans were ones going to their end straight off the train station. There was no guidance on where Liverpool fans should go, so everyone went through the first section. You had Real Madrid fans trying to jump through the ticketing section, police surging back. It was not a pleasant place to be, and from what I've been told, it got a lot worse. It got close to the ground and close to the kickoff as well. But look, I can't talk about things I didn't see with my own eyes. That's what I saw. Beyond that, what I saw on the pitch was a Liverpool team that I thought was the better team on the night, that played the better football, that had the better chances, and came up against Thibaut Courtois, who won man of the match, and rightly so, because exceptional saves. It was a game where, you know, Mo Salah was just amazing. He was absolutely brilliant. You know, he's had a little struggle at times since coming back from AFCON. This looked set to be his crown and achievement. He was on fire, and he was getting into dangerous positions, getting his shots away, and the save in particular, the one that's like the archetypal Mo Salah one across the goalkeeper, and it comes off like the upper arm of Courtois. It's a magnificent save. It's a magnificent goalkeeping performance. And one moment for Madrid is what does it for us. And then you need to dig deep. You need to find moments in the tank. And I suppose the obvious question would be, you know, did going for all four leave Liverpool a little bit lacking in the tank? Maybe, but ultimately I would contend that if it's not for a world-class goalkeeper performance, we probably get something from this game, that we at least take it a bit deeper, maybe take it some extra time, I don't know. But, yeah, look, ultimately, there'll be more detailed analysis to come on this one. It hurts, it really does, and it has to hurt, and if it doesn't hurt, it means you're not alive, and it doesn't matter to you, and it doesn't matter to me very, very much. They love this football club, I love this team. Seeing Virgil van Dijk crying is not what I want to see. He's one of the, probably the player I'm most sad for. I don't know what's going to happen next with Sadio Mane or Mo Salah or Bobby Firmino, but Virgil van Dijk to come back from that injury, to be able to get back to the peak of his powers again, and then just not be able to influence it on the night. Again, much like the last day of the season, it felt like it was written. What I would say again, what we didn't know in Kiev, that we know now, is that I remember coming away from Kiev and thinking, I don't know whether we'll be back here again. I don't know whether we'll have this opportunity. It felt too soon. Liverpool feel like a team at the peak of the powers. Liverpool are a team that's going to win silverware. Liverpool are back 2 pieces of silverware already. I am going to go to the parade tomorrow. I'm going to celebrate this team because it deserves celebrating. We haven't been able to celebrate this team for far too long, since the last time we won the European Cup. And we should go and do that. We should go and get the outpouring of emotion and give it back to this team and screen on and push them on, because in Kiev I didn't know that Liverpool could go again. I'm certain now Liverpool will go again. They will pick themselves up. I don't know how I'm going to do it, but I trust in Jürgen, I trust in those boys to pick themselves up, dust themselves down and go again next season. I don't know what that looks like, but it wouldn't shock me in the slightest to see Liverpool right back at the pinnacle of football once again this time next year. Anyway, that's me, Paul Machen. I hope you had a wonderful season following the Reds. I have. They're the absolute best. They just weren't able to get it over the line here, and that is devastating, but don't worry, we'll carry on. Liverpool will carry on, and they will be back. More to come from us over the summer. We've got loads of stuff to come, but I can't talk about that now. I need to get me bed, get my head down, and go back and celebrate them boys in Liverpool tomorrow.